end up 23-21. We'll be back after this.
When the cold rolls in, it's time to turn on the heater and cozy up with a book. But turning up the heat can mean higher electric bills. And for some families in tough times, that could mean choosing between a warm meal or a warm house. For decades, people like you have extended a hand to help local families in need pay those winter electric bills. Share the warmth this winter to help keep your neighbor warm by giving a little when you pay your Grant PUD bill.
The game is also being broadcast online by Snohomish Times Sports Network. Watch live or
it'll be up
games on YouTube, live channel, NWAC Sports Network, or at NWACSports.com. Also by iFiber Sports at iFiber1.com.
Big Bend up, 9 minutes, 50 seconds to go in the first half of action here in the first round regional matchup at the DeVries Center, and that's a bucket there by Calvin Dennis for Bellevue. 23-all. Meyerhofer with the ball for Big Bend. Gets it to Keyshawn Liggins. Back to Meyerhofer, up top now to A.J. Miles. Let's fly for three. Can't get the bucket. Rebound goes to Michael.
Yeah, that was a deep three right there.
Long shot. King with the ball, guarded by Wyatt Johnson. Pass down low, trying to take advantage now with Lado out of the game. Whistle going to be before the shot?
That was the Vikings number 32.
They call a push like before the shot.
Yeah, Moga's out of the game. Defensive player of the year, and Bellevue's going to take advantage of that.
Yeah, smart to try to work it down low with the big man out for sure. Still got Dennis in for Bellevue. Had a wide lane to the hoop, but they didn't see him. Pulls up for three, no good. Nice effort there by Brunel, who's in the ball game for the first time. Liggins trying to take it coast to coast. Ball goes out of bounds off of Calvin Dennis. Big Ben will maintain possession.
Yeah, we got a couple subs coming in. Leo Beren's going to check in for A.J. Miles, and Riker Pierce checking back in for Wyatt Johnson.
23-all, just under 9 minutes to go in the first half. Keyshawn Liggins with the ball up top to Beren. Back to Liggins. Makes a move to the basket, cut off by King. Nice defense, pulls up for the three. Well off the mark. Brunillo with the rebound, dishes it up top to Meyerhofer. 7 seconds on the shot clock. Riker Pierce with the ball. Big Ben's got to get it up. Riker Pierce lets fly. Wasn't set, kind of falling back. No good on the shot. Rebound King.
Yeah, that shot clock was running down. He had to get something up there.
Got to be a little bit more aware of those precious seconds ticking off. 23-all, 8 minutes to go in the first half. Pierce on King up top now. Brunel switches off on the D. Back up to Michael. Long distance, no good. Liggins runs down the rebound. Big Ben trying to run, but Bellevue back on defense, but a nice pass down low and a bucket by Brunel.
Yeah, Brunel sprinted down that court and got low post position right there and took advantage of it.
25-23, running Vikes. 7:45 to go in the first half. All the way in the corner to Dennis, back up top to King in front of the Big Ben bench. Cross court, pass down low, nice reverse layup, and gets the roll as Dennis.
I tell you, they play that high-low offense very well.
That's Jack Walton, my mistake there, but yeah, nice bucket there, 25-all. Keyshawn Liggins goes down in the paint and gonna have a block go against Jordan Lockett. 17 fouls, so that'll put Liggins on the line for one plus one.
7 minutes to go, knotted up at 25. see free throws here for Big Ben the rest of the way.
The line for the Vikings, number zero, Keyshawn Liggins.
Yeah, a bit of a low-scoring ball game, but boy.
Well, they caught fire there at the beginning. It was 15 minutes to go. You know, we were 19-17 game.
Yeah.
They cooled off a little bit since then, and defensive settled in a little bit.
Well, yeah, and actually Bellevue's extended their defense a little bit with Ladeau out. So, yeah, doing a good effort to keep the running Vikes held in check at the moment. That free throw is good by Liggins. 26-25, Big Ben gets them both. 27-25. 7:15 to go in the first half. King with the ball for Bellevue. Hear the crowd hollering defense for the Vikes. Pierce with the D up top. Moore kicks it back. Now up top to King. We have a whistle on the side here.
O'Neal.
Yep, foul goes against Big Ben. It's Riley Brunil's first. And Ladeau back in. Brunil going to take a seat.
Yeah, good minutes for Brunil, though.
Definitely, and got a nice breather there for Ladeau. 27-25, running Vikes, 6:55 to go in the first half. King with the ball, guarded by Pierce.
I tell you, Big Ben's going to have to really communicate because there's a lot of screening going on out there.
Yeah, and the Bulldogs missed a wide-open cutter down below the bucket. 9 seconds on the shot clock. Meyerhofer with the defense on Michael. Shot no good. Ladeau with the rebound.
I think Ladeau had a little something to do with that miss.
Yeah, you got a guy that big, you got to alter the shot for sure going over him. Barron kicks it off to Meyerhofer. Got a little weave going for the running Vikes. Meyerhofer up top, 15 seconds on the shot clock. Now Ladeau trying to make a move in the paint. Got to get out of there before the whistle. Up top to Meyerhofer, all the way in the corner to Liggins. 3 seconds on the shot clock. Big Ben has to get it off. And Liggins steps on the baseline on that drive, on that move. Yeah, turnover, Big Ben.
Moga's getting great position down low, and they're making him go to his right, and he's not comfortable with that right now.
Well, Big Ben kind of has to mix it up a little bit, too, because they need a second option when they double-team him down low like that, and they're kind of standing around wondering what to do with the ball. And that's a bucket by King, a huge basket there to draw Bellevue even. Whistle on the play going against Barron.
Leo Barron, his first.
So King will try to complete the three-point play here at the line for the Bulldogs. That's a pretty strong move to the hoop there.
You know, Bellevue's come to play, and Big Ben's in for a dogfight.
And that shot bounces over the backboard and out of bounds. And, yeah, you know, this is the kind of game that, you know, as a coach, you're always a little leery of because you got a four seed playing a one seed, you know. And if you're not careful, a four seed will come up and bite you. And right now they're playing pretty even with Big Ben at 27-all here.
After all, it is March Madness, right?
Yeah. It's the ball. Over to Liggins on the far side. Down low to Pierce in the paint. Reverse layup is blocked. They're going to call a travel and a great defensive effort there from Bellevue.
Yeah, they're double tripling down there. And you know what they're doing is they're posting up so low below the block, Big Ben is. When they get the ball, there's nowhere to go but the baseline, and they run out of room.
Yep.
That's like four times tonight.
Yeah, like I said, and they get tied up down there. They need to kick it back out and reset. Draw that defense out a little bit. Double team down low. Big Ben, ball's going to go out of bounds off of Bellevue.
You know, I'm thinking they might want to put Moga at that free throw line area when he posts up and let him go to work from there.
Oh, yeah.
He's got a height advantage there.
Yeah, and that quick first step, you can see him go right by him.
Look where he's at, right at the free throw line, setting a screen.
Riker Pierce with the ball over to the far side to Meyerhofer. Up top now to Liggins. Liggins to Barron, who makes a nice strong move to the hoop. Tries to jam it, but he's fouled. Are they going to call an offensive? Oh, my goodness. He was in the air. I'm not sure how that happens. You know, when you're in the air and a defensive player slides underneath you, there's not a thing you can do.
Yeah, the fans are letting them know what
as an offensive player. That's a questionable call there. Not a favorite with the home crowd, 27-all. Under 5 minutes now to go in the first half. Liggins with the defense in front of the Big Ben bench. Nice little move in the paint, but Williams can't get the bucket. Barron with the rebound.
Boy, Leo got hammered on that rebound right there. No call.
Yeah, they got to go both ways here.
Yep.
Took it in stride, though.
Yep. Didn't complain about
Meyer it. Offer for three. No good. Pierce mistimed the jump there on the rebound. Goes to Bellevue, 27-27. 4 minutes, 15 seconds to go in the first half. Low-scoring ball game here at the DeVries Center. King with the running roller.
Jordan King with the basket.
29-27, yeah, Bellevue.
Pretty soft defense on this end by Big Ben that time down the floor.
Really was, kind of a clear path there to the bucket. Liggins makes a move to the hoop. He's going to be fouled on the way to the bucket. Go to the line for two shots here.
Four, Jordan King is
if
first.
He can't make these two count, not up at
into
29.
Line, number one, Wayne
King
Johnson.
Will be on the line. Excuse me, that's King's second foul of the ball game.
Jonathan Michael.
No, I guess it's his first. They changed it. First foul of the ball game. Keyshawn Liggins on the line for Big Ben. Both teams have eight fouls. First one rolls in.
Yeah, we'll see. It'll be interesting at halftime to see who makes what adjustments.
There will need to be some made for sure because Big Ben's got to figure out a way to shake this pesky Bulldog team here.
Yep.
Second free throw, no good. 29-28, Bellevue. 3 minutes, 45 seconds to go in the first half. Much closer ball game than anticipated here. Walton with the ball. Crossover moving the paint. Can't get it to roll in. Big rebound there by Keyshawn Liggins. Running Vikes out, pushing the ball up court. Ledeau move on the baseline, loses control of the ball. Let's get it up top to Pierce, resets to Liggins, over to Meyerhofer. Kicks it back to Wyatt Johnson for three.
Wyatt Johnson for three.
Yeah, they needed that.
That was a huge bucket for Big Ben here. 31-29, 3 minutes to go in the first half.
You know, when Big Ben was struggling last week against Spokane, Wyatt Johnson came in. He finished tonight with 18.
Yeah, he really did light him up there. Got him going. And somebody will have to catch fire in the second half here for sure. Nice move to the paint, but can't get the bucket. There is Babian. Meyerhofer with the ball now to Wyatt Johnson on the far side of the court. Penetrates the paint, off the glass, no good, but he's fouled, goes to the floor hard.
Yep.
Fouls the Bulldog.
And he'll go to the charity stripe there for two shots.
Strong move.
Wyatt Johnson at the line for the Vikings.
You know, he's another one of those lefties. Big Ben has quite a few of those out here.
Hard to guard.
Yeah, they are. They really are.
Looks like we've got A.J. Miles going to come in for Johnson when he's done shooting free throws. First one's good. No, my mistake. I thought he was coming in for the shooter.
He's going to come in for Keyshawn Liggins.
Number five, Peyton Terrell.
32-29, Big Ben. Second free throw coming from Johnson. That one rolls in. 33-29.
Let's see if Big Ben can't put together a couple more stops here.
2.5 minutes to go, and we're going to get a timeout on the court, a 30-second timeout for the Bulldogs. We're going to step away for a quick commercial break and be right back.
At Les Schwab, along with great prices, our tires come with the kind of protection most other places just don't give you, which includes free flat repairs, equal value replacements, pre-trip safety checks, and more for the entire life of the tire. With the other guys, well, you just never know. So why is free protection on your tires good to have?
Lifetime protection. That's our best tire value promise. Les Schwab, doing the right thing since 1952.
All right, we're back here. 33-29 ball game here. Big bend up. 2 minutes, 29 seconds to go in the first half of this first round regional matchup with Bellevue. Crowd coming alive here.
Yep, it's a big defensive possession right here for Big Ben.
And there's Michael for two. No good. Rebound Ledoux. Man, he is mauled there at the free throw line with no whistle.
Yeah.
Wyatt Johnson with the ball. Over to A.J. Miles. Back up top to Riker Pierce. Johnson lets fly for three. That's short. And a good box out there by Bellevue. Doesn't allow Ledoux to get to the ball.
Yeah. Four-point game. These are big stops for Big Ben right here.
Really are. A minute 50 to go in the first half. 33-29. Running Vikes. Williams with the dribble. Kicks back to King in front of the Big Ben bench. All the way across court to Tyrell. Nice defense up top by Meyerhofer. Leads to a turnover. Big bend, gonna back it up and get their offense set. A.J. Miles up top, guarded by Williams. Now pass down low to Ledoux. We're gonna have a whistle on the play and a grab going against Bellevue.
That's just what I was talking about right there, was get Ledoux at the free throw line where he can turn and go either way he wants.
Yeah, and like we said, he's got a quick first move and you're gonna have people grabbing instead of getting their feet set. And that's exactly what happened there.
It's hard to defend a player from the free throw line when he can go either way.
So, Big Ben now in the double bonus. Ledoux's first free throw bounces off the front of the rim and through. 34-29. Running Vikes, 1:23 left in the first half of action here. Ledoux looking for his seventh point. Can't get it to roll in. Rebound, Michael.
Big Ben's left a few points on the off the board tonight at the line.
They really have. Usually pretty proficient there, but not getting a roll in the first half here. A minute to go. 34-29. Running Vikes holding a slim five-point lead. Long distance shot off the back of the rim by Michael. And Bellevue comes away with the rebound. Pierce with the defense, and he did slap.
Yeah, he's going to be called.
Tyrell on the arm there. His first whistle of the ball game, though.
Yeah, that's a good sign.
Playing pretty strong out there. Got 9 points.
You know, the last few possessions here, Big Ben's turned up their pressure a little bit.
Yeah, definitely not denying those easy buckets down low for sure. That free throw rims out. Meyerhofer with the ball, 27 seconds on the shot clock, 50 on the game clock, 34-29, running Vikes up just before the half. Wyatt Johnson moving the paint off the glass, but he's fouled there. I think it's going against King.
Yep.
Foul of the Bulldogs, number four, Jordan King, his second.
It's like they're clearing out
Wyatt Johnson at the line for the Vikings.
Clearing out on offense here. Getting a little penetration going and getting to the line. That's what they need to do. Now they need to convert.
And Johnson does on that first one. 35-29. Riker Pierce going to get a break.
Keyshawn Liggins going to check in for him.
Ledoux now coming all the way down to the far end of the court. The defensive end for Big Ben. Free throw is up and in for Wyatt Johnson. Gets them both, 36-29. 36 seconds to go in the half. King with the ball. Coach Eggers calling out a play from the bench. They're clearing out for King. Screen by Michael, looking for the pick and roll. Doesn't get it. Great defense there by Meyerhofer. Nice double team by Ledoux. 4 seconds on the shot clock. Long distance shot, no good there by Babion. Shot clock off, 3 seconds on the game clock. Running roller and a foul. Gonna go against Ledoux there.
Foul's the Viking number one, Wyatt Johnson.
No, they're gonna call Wyatt Johnson on that. That's what I thought. Called it before Ledoux got it.
Yeah. Reached in there and hacked him on the way to the hoop. Jordan King on the line with 2 seconds to go in the half. First one rolls through. 36-30, running Vikes. Should have chance to get the ball in and maybe get a shot up.
In for the Bulldogs, number one, Quill Williams.
Quill Williams in for the Bulldogs. King takes his seats. 2 seconds on the shot clock. Meyerhofer will inbound the ball. A.J. Miles got to let it go, and he does from half court. Just short of the mark, and that's going to do it for the first half of play. Big Ben will take a 36-31 lead into the locker room at the break. We'll be back after this commercial break with the halftime report.
Experience speed like never before. When you connect to Grant PUD's high-speed network, visit grantpud.org to learn more.
To save some energy, I've used Einstein's mass energy equivalents to design the haptic suits you see in front of you. They will maintain our core body temperature while we completely turn off our heat and air conditioning. With the money we save on our Grant PUD bill, I'll be expecting that trip to Disneyland this year.
You don't need to be a super genius to save energy and money. Visit grantpud.org to learn how.
Whether you're looking for a bigger car to support your growing family, a new truck for your business, or something to pull that toy of yours, we've got you covered at Barry Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram in Ephrata. Come see us today and learn why your family, friends, and neighbors buy their cars at Barry. On Basin Street for more than 35 years, and with locations in Moses Lake and Wenatchee, we are one great place to buy a car. Call or click 754-2411 or BarrySaves.com.
Country Financial wants to know, what if you could own your future?
I mean, I would spend it with family and friends.
Travel more.
Retire.
Can make decisions that aren't fear-based about money.
At Country Financial, we take the time to get to know you so we can develop a plan with insurance and financial solutions to help you take charge of where you want to be.
Have that fear removed from my mind.
To help you own your future.
To be in control of your future.
Visit ownyourfuture.com to find a local Country Financial representative today.
Surprised you. I really worried about what you were going to do with me. Oh, Mommy, your little love finger pokes. They really tickle me. I am so happy you decided to keep me. I love you, Mommy.
If you find yourself in an unplanned pregnancy, please call Crossroads Pregnancy Resource Centers. They listen, they understand, and they care.
At Les Schwab, along with great prices, our tires come with the kind of protection most other places just don't give you. Which includes free flat repairs, equal value replacements, pre-trip safety checks, and more for the entire life of the tire. With the other guys, you just never know. So why is free protection on your tires a good thing?
Lifetime protection. That's our best tire value promise. Les Schwab, doing the right thing since 1952.
What's white and yellow and red all over? If you said the local book telephone directory, the one with the purple sunset on the cover, then you're right. In print and online at statewideyb.com, it features up-to-date local maps, community information, and a calendar of events. With a restaurant dining guide with full local menus and a reverse directory, you're sure to find the number you're looking for. It's the best way to get the information you need. Pick up a copy of the local book today or visit statewideyb.com.
My family and I were driving our one-day-old son home from the hospital when we got a flat tire. With no spare in our car and nothing but rice fields in sight, we called Les Schwab. When Joe saw us on the side of the road with two babies, he insisted he drive me and the kids home.
Let's get you home safe.
While my husband waited for the tow truck. In no time, Joe's crew had our tire repaired and wouldn't even accept a tip for a ride home, saying it was
baby's first gift.
I'm Estee Wood, and that's my Les Schwab story.
Les Schwab, doing the right thing since 1952.
Experience speed like never before. When you connect to Grant PUD's high-speed network, visit grantpud.org to learn more.
Hi everyone, I'm Christy Goranson, and welcome to Washington Grown. It's a given that every holiday we end up with massive amounts of leftover food that needs to be repurposed. But a lot of people don't know that the farmers in our state are also reusing products and even water. In this episode, we're talking all about leftovers.
We'll head to Fair Start in Seattle to use the classic holiday leftovers, mashed potatoes, and make some salmon cakes.
Who knew that leftovers could be so decadent?
Then we'll chat about the great Missoula floods and see how they left us with some beautiful landscape and impacted Washington agriculture.
I grew up in Washington and I had no idea this was here.
And we'll see how farmers all across our state are reusing leftover irrigation water to conserve while staying efficient. All that and much more on Washington Grown.
Oh! Woo! Is that sick?
Are you ready to cook me up?
Okay, I don't have the hang of this.
So this is where we get our water.
Cheers.
Hopefully they won't eat my shoelaces.
Today, I'm at Fair Start in Seattle. While locals know it as a great lunch spot, Fair Start is a unique place because in addition to being a wonderful restaurant, it's also a culinary job training and placement program for disadvantaged individuals.
Kids that I see that are coming through here, you know, this is their first opportunity to be proud of themselves.
And when I tell people, I mean, why do you go there every week? The food is really good.
Well, one is close. It's great food. And I think more so it's a great opportunity to introduce people to Fair Start who may not be familiar.
And it's good food, right?
And it's great food.
Tell me a little bit about your background and brought you here.
I came from Las Vegas. That's where I was born and raised. I exited the military here at Fort Lewis. So that's what brought me here. And I've had some great ups and some downs here. But coming to this program has put me on my feet on a new level and an empowerment in my mindset that I can do anything.
I met with executive chef Matthew Lassoff to learn more about the program.
This is a beautiful place, but it has a mission.
Our mission is to train cooks and to help elevate lives. We've had some wonderful success stories with our students, and the majority of our students are hired before graduation.
So what's next for you after this?
Ooh, what's next for me? Actually, I work at Safeco now. And that's before getting out of school, by way of coming through this program.
That is incredible. So it just opens up all sorts of doors?
It has opened up a lot of doors for myself and a lot of students.
Later on in the show, Chef Matthew is going to teach me how to make some seared potato cakes using leftover mashed potatoes.
Crispy on the outside and soft on the inside.
Yes, I think we did a good job there, Crispy.
Yes, indeed.
Absolutely delicious.
Leftovers aren't only about food. Farmers across the Columbia Basin utilize leftover irrigation water to conserve and stay efficient with their farming practices. Now I'm off to meet up with potato farmer Mel Calloway at her family farm in Quincy to see how they repurpose their leftover resources.
We've been here since 1951 when the water was delivered, and so yes, we grow potatoes as well as wheat, and then we grow grain corn and dry edible beans like kidney beans and cranberry beans. Yeah.
So when the water was delivered, that is like kind of the key, isn't it?
Yes, yeah. Before water was here, there wasn't anything here but lots of scrub brush and weeds, I guess. So yeah, so until that happened, once the water was delivered, then we learned how to farm this ground. It's very sandy soil. It doesn't have a lot of organic matter in it. And so really water was the key to get some crops growing and get some organic matter back into the ground. And it's incredibly productive ground. So this is our delivery canal to our field. It came under from that lateral canal. It came under the road.
Yeah.
And there's a suction and a pump on the circle back there that lifts the water up and then irrigates the field with it. So any water that doesn't get pulled up into the system and a little leftover water goes on down to the next farm. And any water that doesn't get used here eventually gets used on a farm somewhere in the basin. So. Thousands of miles long, but an incredibly efficient system to water the fields.
Now, so the way things are set up today seems like you can really conserve.
Oh, definitely. Yeah, water's really important to us here in the basin. I mean, without it, we wouldn't be one of the most productive areas in the United States. And we're very consistent in the products that we deliver out of this state, and it's because we have water. Yeah, we can control it.
I wanted to take a closer look at the Calloway potato fields, so Mel took me over the bridge and through the fields to check them out.
This is a russet Burbank field. It's contracted for frozen potato production.
Okay.
Russet Burbanks are pretty large and blocky, and they just make an excellent French fry. We have water monitoring systems located in every field, and then we always use our shovel to dig things up and find out, you know, just to kind of look underneath and what's going on. So.
Mel showed me what to look for when checking in on the potatoes.
Here's the potato hill underneath all this foliage here. So
this is the mound.
So one of the things we definitely look for is to make sure this foliage is all nice and healthy underneath here, and it is.
Mel says these potatoes still have a few more months to grow before they'll be harvested.
It's got a long ways to go.
Will these get?
I mean, he'll get about that big, so he'll get quite a bit bigger.
Yeah.
That's only about a 6-ounce size, and we want them to be 12 to 16.
We ended our tour by visiting the equipment shed. This harvesting equipment helps the Calloways bring in up to 14,000 tons, or a football field of potatoes.
What do you want people to know about the farmers of Washington State?
The majority of us are family farms, and this is our livelihood. And it's important to us to preserve that livelihood and pass on the next generation. I think we take a lot of pride in the fact that we have the ability to grow food. And not just for Washington State, but for the rest of the world.
And you're conservationists too.
Definitely, we definitely value the fact that we have irrigation water here on a consistent basis. So I think it's important that people know we put a lot of value in the entire environment.
Mm-hmm. A lot of love. And you feed the world.
And to feed the world, definitely.
It's kind of a big deal.
Yeah, it's pretty exciting.
Using leftovers can save time in meal preparation and get food from fridge to table in a jiff. However, it's good to know a few facts beyond the sniff test. When it comes to leftovers, certainly the best rule is, when in doubt, throw it out. But to get the most out of your food, there's more to consider. The longer a cooked perishable food like meat or eggs has been in your refrigerator or freezer, the more the vitamin content declines. That's because vitamins are vulnerable to oxygen and temperature changes. As food sits in your fridge, bacteria, mold, and yeast may start to grow. So to keep food safe and at peak quality, quickly refrigerate perishable foods like meat, fish, dairy, and eggs. Don't let them sit more than 2 hours at room temperature. Uncooked foods such as cold potato salads and sandwiches should be refrigerated as soon as possible. Cooked meats can stay in the fridge for 3 to 4 days and in the freezer for 2 to 3 months. Fresh berries can remain in the fridge for 3 to 5 days and in the freezer for up to a year. Fresh vegetables can stay 3 to 7 days in the fridge but can be frozen for 8 months to a year. By following a few safety tips, you can keep your Washington-grown food safe from farm to table and from fridge to plate.
Coming up, we're back in Seattle at Fair Start to use some leftover mashed potatoes and whip up some salmon cakes.
Absolutely delicious.
Just about ready to start second half action here. The first round of the regional tournament at Big Bend with the Running Vikes up over the Bellevue Bulldogs. Just want to give a quick shout out to some of the local teams who participated in the state basketball tournament over the weekend. Some are still involved, but the Moses Lake girls come away with a close 62-58 win this morning over Lewis and Clark to take fourth in the tournament. They finished with their best record ever, 25-1, and their only loss is to Central Valley in the first round of the tournament, who looks like they'll probably end up winning at Duke. And then the ACH girls played well. They lost their first game but came back to win their next couple and finished fourth with a 69-38 win over Tohola this morning. ACH boy, actually Lynn Ritzville just finished up fifth place finish with a loss to Brewster, and now the ACH boys number one ranked in the state going against Nia Bay for the championship later on this afternoon in 1B ball.
Yep. Lots of basketball going on.
Yeah, so great effort by the local teams, and we just got the second half underway here at Big Bend, and the first bucket is gonna go to Bellevue.
That's Jack Walton again. Offensive rebound and a putback.
So we'll see if he can complete the three-point play here. But yeah, great effort by all the local area high school teams. All probably sad that the season come to an end, but all needing a break too, because spring sports is right around the corner.
Yep, baseball season's beginning.
36-34, Running Vikes. JJ Eli with the ball. Pierce kicks it back in the corner to Eli for three. No good. Rebound Williams for the Bulldogs.
We'll see what Coach Both drew up here and what he expects here in the second half.
And that's an air ball there from Walton, and Ladol gets the ball on a, trying to save it was Dennis there. 36-34, second half just underway. Ladol with the screen. Meyerhofer doesn't use it. Liggins now trying to make a move. Pulls up in the paint, can't get the roll. Williams with the rebound.
Yeah, that's not the start I don't think Big Ben was looking for here.
Yeah, Liggins needs to get off. He doesn't have any, well, he's got 3 points, I guess, in the ball game here. And, you know, he hit some big three-pointers in the last game against Spokane that caught Big Ben on fire. Let's see if he can get it going here in the second half.
Yeah, somebody's gonna have to step up for Big Ben on the offensive end.
Good defense by the Vikes. 3 seconds on the shot clock, turnover. Bellevue, Liggins trying to go coast to coast off the glass, no good. Rebound Dennis. Outlet pass to Williams.
I think Keyshawn is trying to get a foul there. He didn't get it called.
So. Yep. 36-34, Running Vikes. Eli on the defense in the far side, and we got a whistle down low.
We got Keyshawn with a hold.
Number zero, Keyshawn Liggins, his first.
That's his first foul of the ball game. Second team foul of the half for Big Bend. Just over 18 minutes to go in the ball game. Williams lets fly from long distance. That's good.
Quill Williams with the basket.
He's gonna put Bellevue up 37-36.
Yeah, the Bulldogs edge out front here early in the second half. Meyerhofer with the ball to Riker Pierce on the far side here. Liggins up top, screened by Meyerhofer, doesn't roll to the hoop. Dishes off to Ladeau, gets his man in the air. Bucket is gonna count.
That's what I was telling you earlier, is that shooting one. I thought they need to get him away from the basket, get him off the post, and let him do some work outside. You know, that's his third foul already for Calvin Dennis, and they've all been by Mogo going to the basket.
Yeah, that's a great formula for success there for Big Ben, if they can get the ball down low like that and get the foul stacking up against the big man for Bellevue.
You know, he's one of their key guys, but it seems, you know, Bellevue has been fine without him.
Ladeau converts the three-point play, 39-37, and yeah, Bellevue's really missing Zare out there for sure.
Yeah, they are.
This tight of a ball game. There's a move across the paint by Walton. And then a double team effort there by Big Ben and a block by Ladeau. Riker Pierce step over move.
Riker Pierce for two.
Gets the bucket.
Yep. Nice move.
Really was. That's 11 points for Riker Pierce, leading scorer in the ball game.
You know, we haven't seen Big Ben get a few stops and get out and run much.
No, Bellevue hasn't allowed him that opportunity at all.
And that's their offense, too. They want to get out and run. And if you can't stop him from scoring, you can't run.
Yep. Long distance shot from King is good.
Great example right there.
41-40, and you're right, that is the missing piece here because Big Ben gets a lot of points off the break, and there's a nice move and a bucket by Eli. Kind of lulled his defender to sleep there and went right by him.
You know, we haven't seen that tonight. That'll wake Bellevue up a little bit.
43-40, running Vikes. 16 and a half minutes to go in this one. Liggins with the defense now up top to Williams. He makes a move in the paint. Kicks back, but nobody there to get it, although Michael was fortunate enough to run it down there for Bellevue. Meyerhofer with the defense.
Tough shot.
Tough shot. You can't do any better than that. And then it's a bucket there by Michael.
Yeah, they have. You know, you have a lot of one-on-one players here for Bellevue. They can create their own shots.
43-42, running Vikes. Meyerhofer now with the ball. Makes a move past Walton. Can't get the ball to roll in. King with the rebound for Bellevue. Bulldogs out and running. Big Ben gets back. The long distance shot from Michael. Rattles in.
Jonathan Michael for two.
45-43, Bellevue. 15:40 to go in the ball game. That's going to draw a timeout from Big Ben. It's going to be a 30-second timeout. We're going to step away for a quick break and be right back.
At Les Schwab, along with great prices, our tires come with the kind of protection most other places just don't give you, which includes free flat repairs, equal value replacements, pre-trip safety checks, and more for the entire life of the tire. With the other guys, well, you just never know. So why is free protection on your tires good to have?
Lifetime protection. That's our best tire value promise. Les Schwab, doing the right thing since 1952.
Broadcasting live from I-51 Communicate.
We got ourselves a ball game here this afternoon, folks, at the DeVries Center. Bellevue up 45-43, 15 and a half minutes to go in the ball game. Winner advances in the winner's bracket here. Loser falls down in the consolation group.
Yeah, Big Ben found himself in a little hole here. Bellevue's on a 14-7 run coming out the second half here.
Yeah, they've looked pretty good here and just won't go away. Every time Big Ben gets a bucket, Bellevue's there to answer. And that is a great big body on Liggins. No foul, and Eli comes up with the ball in the bucket for Big Ben.
Yeah, that's a big play. They got to get some stops and some runouts.
45 all. King with the ball for Bellevue. Screen by Walton. Defense by Pierce. Now Williams making a move in the paint. Left-handed layup, no good. Oh, and the loose ball goes to Walton. Look what I found up and in for two. Right place at the right time.
I tell you, they are putting some points on the board here.
47-45. Bellevue, Riker Pierce, nice strong move to the hoop, but can't get the ball to roll in, but he will go to the line for two shots.
Riker Pierce, what Bellevue's shooting, you know, that first half here, they were shooting 44%, but it's better than that to start the second half.
Yeah, everything they seem to offer up is going through right now. Pierce on the line for two. First one is in.
In for the Vikings, number one, Wyatt Johnson. For the Bulldogs, number two, Jordan Lockhart. And number five, Peyton Terrell.
47-46, Bellevue. Pierce gets both of them, ties the ball game with 14:44 to go. 47 all. King calling out a play for the Bulldogs.
Looks like Meyerhofer's checked in for Keyshawn Liggins here.
Meyerhofer on the defense on Michael. That's a walk.
Rather, Wyatt Johnson. Excuse me. Wyatt Johnson's checked in.
Changed his pivot foot there, with Michael did. So turnover against Bellevue. Eli with the ball to Ladeau. Johnson trying to get the ball down low to Pierce, but he was guarded well there by Tyrell. Pierce in the corner in front of Big Ben's bench. No good, and Johnson steals the rebound and a putback jam by Ladeau for two.
Let's see if that'll spark Big Ben here a little bit somehow.
Got the crowd and the mascot rolling all over the floor. They're jacked up. You can hear them chatting now for defense. From the running Vikes, 49-47. Big Ben turnover, Bellevue. Eli with the ball. All the way across court to Wyatt Johnson. Bounce pass down low to Ladeau. Double teamed by Bellevue, but it doesn't matter.
Olga Ladeau.
Here's one of those runs that Big Ben needs to have.
There you go. They're on an 8-2 run right at the moment here, I believe. 13:20 to go in the ball game. 51-47, Big Ben.
Might have got away with a walk.
Did. King with the ball, double teamed by the Vikes. 10 seconds on the shot clock, and that's Lockhart letting fly with a long one. No good. Rebound, Meyerhofer.
Great defense by Big Ben on that possession.
It took people to wake up here, a little bit to wake up here, Duke, but everybody is up and on their feet now and cheering on the running Vikes. Johnson lets fly and gets the roll.
Wyatt Johnson.
3 points, three. Big Ben. Biggest lead of the ball game now for the running Vikes, 54-47.
I was thinking Bellevue might want to get a timeout, but he's going to roll the dice.
12 and a half minutes to go, 54-47. And they get a lucky roll there on the shot from King. And that's going to draw a timeout for the Bulldogs.
30-second
timeout. It'll be a 30-second timeout. I think we're just going to stay here. 12 and a half minutes to go. Big Ben up, 54-49.
Yeah, 54-49. And I tell you what, Bellevue came to play. It's exciting.
Yeah, and they made a nice little trip over the hill. It's a little bit of a drive for them. And not much of a crowd showing up with them, but I tell you what, they're right in this ball game.
Yeah, well, they're over there in the mecca of basketball right now with all the state finals going on. So,
yep.
So many schools over there, and they're all playing at the Tacoma Dome, Yakima Sun Dome.
Right.
Even Spokane.
Yeah, there are a few teams from the west side over at 1B ball for sure.
So Bellevue got a basket back, and that was a big bucket for them.
Really was, so that gets them again within 5 points here. 54-49, 12 and a half minutes to go. Eli with the ball for Big Ben, guarded by King. Got a quick whistle here. Shot clock needs to be reset. Still trying to figure it out. They got 27 seconds on the clock. The shot clock, that is.
Might be talking about the game clock.
Could be. I didn't think that they reset the clock when they started, when they threw it in. But yeah, you're right. Maybe a couple seconds off the
Took
game
off
clock.
Took off a here. Second. Okay.
Boy, you know.
Oh.
Yeah, that's not going to work.
How many seconds this guy going to take off?
So officials will talk it over there in front of the scoreboard. And they took a couple seconds off the shot clock too, but maybe that was just winding down when they started the play. So I guess they got it straightened out, but nothing's changed.
Yeah.
All right, here we go.
They just wanted a conference call.
Hey. A little breather themselves, maybe. Riker Pierce up top, guarded by Michael. A little grab, but no call. Strong move to the hoop, and a late whistle. Yeah, that was the lead official's call, but he didn't call it. Trail official got him on the arm. And Michael, that is. First foul going against him, but that'll put Pierce on the line for two.
Riker Pierce at the line for the Vikings.
Yeah. Strong move by Riker to get to the line.
Really was. Got a late whistle, but they got it right. And Pierce will go to the line for two shots here and try to up the Big Ben lead. First one is in. 14 points for Pierce.
See if they can't do better than 10 for 15 in the first half at the line.
Second one is no good. Tap back by Meyerhofer. Big Ben maintains possession, resets the shot clock.
We'll see how big that tip back and offensive rebound was here.
Yeah, they get a bucket here. That's huge. Meyerhofer to Eli. Strong move to the hoop, off the glass and in.
That's it.
You know, that credit all goes to Meyerhofer right there. He's the one that got that to happen.
Really was, and that's a tough shot for a right-hander driving to the left side of the bucket and putting it up with his right hand.
This may be the biggest lead of the game.
It is, 57-49 now, running Vikes up by eight. Long distance shot off the back of the rim, no good, rebound.
That's going to be his fourth, I believe, on Calvin Dennis.
Yeah, the rebound actually looked like it went over to Dennis, but you're right, they caught him with a push on the play, and that's his fourth foul of the ball game.
Yeah, that's a big point in this game with 11:37.
Yeah, you'll see Big Ben now trying to probably take advantage of that and try to get the ball down low again to Ladeau, like you were talking about earlier. 57-49, running Vikes. Wyatt Johnson, back to Meyerhofer, over to Eli. Spin move, off the glass, no good. Put back by Ladeau, no good. Meyerhofer tries to keep it alive, can't do it. That's Walton with the ball. They're gonna get Pierce on the arm for that. Good defense, just caught him on the arm.
You know, that Big Ben just come up short on that hustle play. It was a free ball and it just happened to go to Bellevue.
Yeah, got caught trying to catch up to the ball and Pierce was whistled for a reach.
It's only Pierce's second, so that's a good sign.
Three Big Ben players now in double figures in the ball game. You got Wyatt Johnson with 10, Eli with 13, and Pierce with 14. J.J. Eli on the verge with 9. Free throws good by Walton, 57-50, Big Ben, 11-14 to go in the ball game. Riker Pierce lets fly from long distance. No good, rebound, King.
Yeah, great look.
Really was, he's just off a little bit from long distance. Wyatt Johnson on the defense. King steps back and nails a three.
Jordan King with the basket.
Yeah, I don't know, that miscommunication there by Big Ben.
Got Bellevue within 4, 57-53, and Ladeau is fouled on that play.
Fouls the Bulldog number 24, Quentin Moore.
And he'll go to the charity stripe for two attempts here. That's four fouls on Quentin Moore. So Bellevue in a little bit of foul trouble here, second half.
Yeah. Bogus free throws off the mark. Knock these down. They're going to be important come down the stretch.
Yeah, only a 4-point spread here. They got to hit everything at the line now. Gets a second one to go. 58-53, Big Ben. 10 minutes, 40 seconds to go.
You know, watching Bellevue out here, they're all freshmen suited up here except for one.
Wow.
And that's Akel Williams. And
jump shot for three over Riker Pierce by Michael.
Yep.
Gets Bellevue within a bucket. 58-56. The Bulldogs will not go away. Wyatt Johnson for three. Rattles out. Meyerhofer keeps the ball alive, and it's going to go out of bounds off Michael.
Meyerhofer's hanging around tonight. He's making a few things happen.
Yeah, not a lot of points on the board, but boy, is he hustling on the defensive end. He'll throw it in from the baseline. Gets it to Eli, 30 seconds on the shot clock. Pierce, nice give and go, and a back door.
That's a great set play,
play
right
by Big Ben.
Yeah.
60-56, running Vikes. Michael with the ball. Oh, Williams penetrates off the glass, no good, but gonna draw a foul against Wyatt Johnson.
Yeah, late call, but it was a foul. He's not complaining about it.
That's his third whistle of the ball game. Williams on the line, gonna shoot two for Bellevue. First one bounces over the front of the rim and in.
The guy that's at the line here is the only sophomore suited up tonight for Bellevue.
That's amazing.
Yeah.
He's the only one of two on the team.
Yeah, the other one,
they're
Brian
all freshmen,
Zares,
yeah,
sitting out with an injury.
Yeah, so a young team here, and they're holding their own against Big Ben. Ledoux having trouble and has got his shot rejected. King pulls up from the free throw line, no good. Put back by Moore, no good. Williams runs down the loose ball for Bellevue. Double team by Big Ben. Gets out of it. Great hustle there by Williams.
Yeah, I tell you, they are scrapping. You know, one thing Coach Eggers for Bellevue said before the game was an offensive foul on Bellevue there.
But yeah, gonna go against Michael, I think.
Yeah, but what he was saying was, you know, they don't have the experience Big Ben does. They might not be as talented as Big Ben. They're gonna have to play smarter, and they're gonna have to play harder, and they're young. And he said that's the only chance they got. Right now they're doing that.
Well, they got a pretty good chance. They're down by two, like I said, 60-58 with 9 minutes to go. So they're showing some pretty good poise out there for such a young team. Pierce guarded by King, now up top to Eli. On the wing to to Keyshawn Liggins, down low to Pierce. He gets a shot off, goes hard to the floor. Whistle.
Yep. He'll have a couple shots coming.
Who's the foul on? I didn't see him call it out.
Fouls the Bulldogs, number 30, Jack.
That's
Walton. His third. Riker Pierce at the line.
Walton's third foul of the contest. 8:48 to go. Big Ben up 60-58. Pierce on the line for two.
There you go. These are going to count here from here on out.
Boy, I tell you, yeah.
It's crunch time.
Big Ben going to be in the bonus from here on out. So, yeah, you're right. They got to make them count. 17 points now for Riker Pierce, leading scorer in the ball game. Ledoux with 14. Second one's up and in. 4-point spread, 62-58, running Vikes. King with the ball. Bellevue lets fly from long distance, off the rim, no good. Ledoux with the rebound.
See if Big Ben can't convert here on that missed opportunity by Bellevue.
Keyshawn Liggins to Pierce. Nice drive, can't get the ball to roll in, but he's gonna go to the line again.
Yeah, attack that basket. That's Walton's fourth.
Riker Pierce at the line for the Vikings.
So Bellevue's two guns, Walton and Calvin Dennis, both with four. Bellevue coach is letting them have it right now too.
That's definitely big there, because those two big men in trouble gonna give Big Ben free access to the hoop.
In for the Bulldogs.
You know, and coming in, you know, Bellevue, they're young, they're inexperienced, they're a number four seed, you're on the road to the number one seed, not just a one seed, number one in the NWAC.
Yeah.
And more or less, you come in with nothing to lose. You're not supposed to win anyway.
Yep, let it all hang out here.
And that's what they're doing, and they've put on a show.
Yeah, and you got to hand it to them. 64-58, 8 minutes, 13 seconds to go, and they're giving Big Ben everything they could ask for and more here.
I'll tell you what, Big Ben needs this.
They do. They need a tester in the first game, but they definitely got to come out with a win.
Yeah. You know, this could be a wake-up. If they come away with a W here, it'll be a wake-up call.
Yeah, long-distance shot by Michael, no good. Pierce with the rebound, and now he makes a strong move to the hoop and gets the fall in off the glass there. 66-58, running Vikes. Going to draw a timeout from Bellevue.
30.
It's going to be a 30-second timeout. We're going to step away for a quick break and be right back.
To save some energy, I've used Einstein's mass energy equivalents to design the haptic suits you see in front of you. They will maintain our core body temperature while we completely turn off our heat and air conditioning. With the money we save on our Grant PUD bill, I'll be expecting that trip to Disneyland this year.
You don't need to be a super genius to save energy and money. Visit grantpud.org to learn how.
'66-58, running Vikes up. 7 minutes, 44 seconds to go, Duke. We got a ball game here.
We do. You know, we just talked before that timeout that Bellevue has nothing to lose. You know, they're not supposed to win looking on paper. And not only are you young, you're number four seed on the road to the number one in the NWAC, but your best player's out. So you come in here and roll the dice and say, give it everything you got, because you got nothing to lose. And right now it's worked out.
It really has. And like you said, you know, it's given Big Ben a good test here, and one that you kind of want to have, a little stiff opponent to get things rolling, but one you'd like to have a little bit easier time with, too.
Yeah, you know, you're supposed to have is being a number one seed. You know,
yep.
But, hey, anything happens, this is March Madness in the NWAC, too.
Yep, definitely. Yeah, good start to the regional playoffs here at the DeVries Center. Lots of action. Here's a strong move to the hoop. And he's going to get the bucket as Michael, and the foul going against Big Ben. They're going to be on Pierce.
I think so.
Vikings number 12, Riker yep. Pierce, his third.
You know, that's a great Jonathan call Michael for Bellevue out of bounds, coming away with a bucket and a foul.
Yeah, gets him within six. 66-60. See if Michael can convert the three-point play, and he does. Five-point ball game here, folks, with 7.5 minutes to go. Big Ben up, 66-61. Now we got backcourt pressure from Bellevue. A.J. Miles all the way across court to Pierce. Miles now with the ball up top. Gets it back to Pierce. Drives to the hoop. And that's going to be a charge. Yeah, out of control on that play. Kind of scrambling for the loose ball. Both wants an explanation here. Everybody kind of scrambling for it there, and the whistle goes against Pierce, but you're right, it's fourth in the ball game, and they can't have him on the pine, but he might have a rest here.
It looks like Wyatt Johnson might be coming in for him.
Yeah, and if Bellevue's smart, they'd take it right at Pierce while he's still in there. And that's a nice reverse layup by Michael to get the Bulldogs within three. 66-63 with just under 7 minutes to go.
You know, every time Big Ben makes a run, Bellevue responds.
Eli, off the glass. Don't think he called it, but he'll take it.
I don't know if he did or not. It looked... I thought it was going over the top of the backboard, to be honest
with you. Yeah, that's a big bucket, though. 69-63, running Vikes. King in the corner. Down low to Williams. Looks like he carried the ball, but no call. Doesn't get the shot to roll in. Keyshawn Liggins with the rebound all the way cross court here to Pierce. Let's fly for three. No good, but I think Williams might have got a piece of that ball.
Yeah.
King comes away with it for Bellevue. He launches one from long distance. No good.
Don't foul.
Yeah, rebound Tyrell and a block by Ladeau, but a putback by King.
King with the basket.
69-65. Big Ben and a jam there from Ladeau.
Yeah, Bellevue just didn't get back on that.
Yeah, they got caught short in transition there, and Big Ben made him pay. 71-65, running Vikes, 5 minutes, 40 seconds to go. Strong screen up top by Dennis. Ladeau comes away with the ball. Back to Miles. Thought about dishing it back to Lado, but kind of got caught in the middle. And
yeah, that was a great missed opportunity right there. That was a big, big missed opportunity.
Williams with the ball now for Bellevue. Gives it off to King, guarded by Liggins. Eli takes over, nice drop off. The pounce, that should be a walk. And it was. Good defense there, a help there down low by Eli.
Becker was holding his breath on that call.
Yeah. Yep, and he finally gets to take a break here. And the whole crowd just kind of breathes a sigh of relief that he's out of the ball game for the moment.
6-point lead with 5:10 to go here. We'll see if Big Ben can get a bucket and a stop.
71-65, running Vikes. 5 minutes to go. Eli gets a screen from Lado.
I kind of agree with that. He wasn't set, really.
Yeah.
Number five, Moga Lado, his third.
You know, that's not Moga's fault. That's, I don't know if that was Wyatt Johnson who penetrated there.
Yeah.
But he penetrated when Moga was coming up to set the screen, and he didn't get set at all.
Quick whistle. That's Lado's third foul of the ball game. Meyerhofer back in. Miles going to sit down. 71-65, running Vikes. Just under 5 minutes to go. Walton with the ball. Now to King, and a steal by Meyerhofer. Triple teamed in the corner there. We get the timeout.
Yep.
He does. He gets the timeout.
Smart move by Meyerhofer there, getting the steal, and he was triple teamed and got the timeout.
He really was. Let's see how long we're going to step away. 30-second timeout by Big Ben. We'll just stay here. 4 minutes, 37 seconds to go in the ball game. And Duke got some accolades here, maybe for Big Ben.
I do, you know. We might as well get it out there and throw them out there. The All League Awards were announced, and for the Eastern Region, and Riker Pierce, most valuable player.
Don't forget to check out the
second team, JJ Eli. Oh, first team, excuse me, Moga Lado. I hope you can hear me. It's pretty loud.
Yeah, it's loud.
But for the MVP was Riker Pierce. He was also the freshman of the year. The defensive player of the year, Moga Lado. And also all defensive team, JJ Eli and Keyshawn Liggins. Coach of the year, Mark Poth from Big Ben. So lots of kudos to Big Ben and lots of guys that earned it all year
long.
Yeah,
well deserved. Yeah, they really have worked hard out there. And yeah, kudos, like you said, to the whole program. 71-65, Big Bend with 4.5 minutes to go. Meyerhofer, Liggins, look like Big Ben going to try to run a little bit of time off the clock, but can't run too much. 7 seconds to go. Lado makes a move to the hoop, and he's fouled by Calvin Dennis.
Number 32, Calvin Dennis, his fifth. Moga Lado at the line for the Vikings.
Bob, where'd Moga catch that ball at? Free throw line.
Where you said, yeah, get it to him at the free throw line.
It just makes sense, you know. And
Bulldogs,
he has room to work, and he has to put their big guys on the move. When he catches it down low on the block, they're just standing flat-footed and don't have to do anything. And like you said, he's got a quick first step, and he can penetrate.
Definitely. And so, yeah, that advantage Big Ben on that exchange for sure. And
so you got Jack Walton with four fouls, and he's done damage tonight on Big Ben.
Quentin Moore with four as well Bellevue.
They're both in there now with four fouls.
Free throw rims out. 71-65, running Vikes, just over 4 minutes to go. King with the ball, guarded by Liggins. Dishes off to Michael, Lado on the defense. Step back, no good on that long distance shot. Wyatt Johnson with the rebound. Meyerhofer with the ball in front of the Big Ben bench. Up top to Johnson. Dishes back to Liggins. 17 seconds on the shot clock. Eli with the ball, calling out the set. Johnson to Liggins in the far side. Strong move to the paint. Dishes off to Lado and loses the ball out of bounds. Not a good pass.
You know, they ran some time off the clock, but I tell you, you got to execute at the end. Just miscommunication.
Yep. Need some points for sure. You see Riker, Pierce jogging in place. They're trying to stay loose. And he gets the chance to come back in the ball game. 3.5 minutes to go. Big bend up, 71-65. King tries to draw the foul, but no dice.
They got numbers. They need to take advantage.
Big bend. Yeah, great defense, though, by Bellevue. And they come away with the ball. And that's going to be an easy bucket for Williams.
Yeah, that's just bad luck right there,
yeah,
for Big Ben.
Gets the Bulldogs within four. Pierce up off the bench, chomping at the bit to get back in. 71-67. He will come in on the next dead ball. Wyatt Johnson all the way across court to Eli for three.
J.J.
Huge bucket there from Eli.
That was a huge bucket.
Big Ben up by seven with under 3 minutes to go. 74-67. Move to the hoop by Williams. That's going to draw a foul from Eli. Brings both up off the bench.
J.J. Eli, his third.
Now you got both coaches over there screaming in that ref's ear here with 2:40 to go. I mean, they want everything they can get.
Pierce been standing on the sidelines for a minute trying to get back in this ball game. 74-67, running Vikes. Williams on the line, misses the first one.
In for the Vikings, number 12.
Riker Pierce back on the court. Liggins gonna sit down. 74-67, running Vikes. 2 minutes, 43 seconds to go. Aquil Williams on the line. Misses the second one. Pierce with the rebound.
Two big misses.
They were huge misses there. Eli with the ball over to Meyerhofer on the far side. Back to Johnson up top. Pierce guarded by Michael. Dishes back to Meyerhofer. Wyatt Johnson, 10 seconds on the shot clock. To Meyerhofer. Off to Ladeau. They're going to say that Meyerhofer stepped on the baseline.
Yeah, I'm a little bit blocked by that view, but I'm out.
I'm looking right at it. I didn't see it, but I'm not as close as the ref. 74-67, 2 minutes to go. Running Vikes, trying to hold on here. Hear the crowd chanting defense. Moore with the ball for Bellevue, guarded by Ladeau, cross court to Williams. Pulls up the paint, dishes off to Moore for two.
Yeah, that's great offense by Bellevue.
Could have been a delay of game there on the Bulldogs, but no whistle. Under 2 minutes to go now, 74-69. Pierce lets fly for three, no good. Johnson tries to keep it alive, but King comes away with it for Bellevue, pushing the ball up court for the Bulldogs. Guarded by Wyatt Johnson, back to Walton up top. Coach Eggers off the bench calling out a play for Bellevue. King with the ball, he's got a free path to the hoop. Gonna draw the foul, but doesn't get the bucket.
Looks like they're gonna call it on J.J. Eli, I believe.
Coach Poth has a little bit to say about that one.
Yeah, you know, Big Ben down here on the offensive end has been very sloppy these last four possessions.
And boy, oh boy, getting a break from the free throw line and all those misses here from Bellevue down the stretch.
Yeah, you need to take advantage of that if you're Big Ben.
This could easily be a one-point ball game had they made their shots from the free throw line here. King with a second attempt, makes that one. 74-70, Big Ben, a buck 27 on the clock. Eli with the ball, guarded by Williams, now to Johnson, back up top to Meyerhofer. Gets it to Pierce, guarded closely there by Michael. Spin move. He's going to be fouled on that shot.
I believe that's Quentin Moore. Is that?
That'll be five.
Johnson,
nope.
Michael.
Oh, they're going to give it to Michael. He got a break there.
Yeah.
Record Pierce at the line for the Vikings.
We'll see.
Yep.
Most valuable player of the Eastern region. That's who you'd want at the line.
You betcha. Big Ben and a double bonus now here, so you get two shots for sure, even if he wasn't shooting. First one is in, 75-70, Big Ben. Minute 12, it's 23 points for Pierce, leading scorer in the ball game. Second one bounces out, but he gets his own rebound, gives it to Wyatt Johnson, and Big Ben will reload. 26 seconds on the shot clock. Going to be a fouling situation here shortly for Bellevue.
I think they might.
And they had
great call right there.
Yeah, they had the trap there on Pearson. Big Ben gets a quick timeout. It's going to be a full timeout, so we're going to step away for a commercial break and be back with Big Ben up 75-70.
Whether you're looking for a bigger car to support your growing family, a new truck for your business, or something to pull that toy of yours, we've got you covered at Barry Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram in Ephrata. Come see us today and learn why your family, friends, and neighbors buy their cars at Barry. On Basin Street for more than 35 years, and with locations in Moses Lake and Wenatchee, we are one great place to buy a car. Call or click 754-2411 or BarrySaves.com.
Broadcasting live from I-501 Community.
75-70, running Vikes up with under a minute to go in the ball game. This first round matchup here in the regional playoffs with Bellevue. And the Bulldogs have just been sticking around the whole ball game here, Duke.
They have. They got 10 on the shot clock, Big Ben.
Yeah, now they're finally aware of it, and Eli's got to get it up. Here's Johnson. Kicks it to Meyerhofer, gets it off, and gets the three at the buzzer. What a big basket for Big Ben. 78-70, running Vikes, and a steal by Johnson. 35 seconds on the clock. Whistle going against Bellevue.
Huge basket by Connor Meyerhofer.
My goodness.
Offensively, he's been rather quiet tonight. Probably hit the biggest shot of the game right there.
Really did, because Big Ben looked absolutely lost there, and time running out on the shot clock, and he gets it off at the buzzer, and it goes in. Big basket.
That foul was called on Jack Walton, and that's his fifth, so that's why we got a little stall here.
Yeah.
You know, I was curious watching Bellevue in that last timeout with 14 on the shot clock. They chose not to foul.
Right.
Try to get a stop.
Right.
Because there was still 59 on the clock. And I probably would have done the same thing too, but Connor hit a huge shot.
Huge. The Wyatt Johnson now has a chance to really put this one away. Big Ben up 78-70 with 34 ticks left on the game clock. Gets the first one. One more will pretty much ice it. Give him a 10-point lead. And he gets it. That's his 12th point of the ball game. King gets the bucket, and there's going to be a foul going against Meyerhofer, it looks like, and he's wondering what the heck went on there.
The Vikings, number three, Connor Meyerhofer.
Yeah, I don't have any idea where that call came from.
Jordan King at the line for the Bulldogs.
Yeah, he wasn't
looks
even.
Like he just flew by.
Yeah, he wasn't close to touching the defender, but that'll put King on the line.
And for the Vikings, number 12, Riker Pierce.
Going to get Riker back in here for offense.
80-72, running Vikes up with 29 ticks left on the game clock. Shot clock is off. Big Ben looking to hold on and advance in the winner's bracket here in the first round of the regional tournament.
Both maybe going offense for defense here.
Free throw is no good. We got a whistle going against Bellevue.
So he might bring Mogo back in. We'll see what he does here. Thought he was going to sub a little offense for defense.
Connor Meyerhofer at the line for the Vikings.
Yeah, probably maybe just going to see how this thing plays out here. If Meyerhofer makes these two free throws, and he can just rest his big man the rest of the way, I think, and he gets the first one.
Into the Bulldog, number 24.
81-72, running Vikes. 28 seconds to go. Meyerhofer gets them both. 82-72. Michael with the ball pulls up for two. Gets that to go.
He's
going to draw a quick timeout from Bellevue. That's going to be a full timeout, so we're going to step away for a commercial break and be right back.
At Les Schwab, along with great prices, our tires come with the kind of protection most other places just don't give you, which includes free flat repairs, equal value replacements, pre-trip safety checks, and more for the entire life of the tire. With the other guys, well, you just never know. So why is free protection on your tires good to have?
Lifetime protection. That's our best tire value promise. Les Schwab, doing the right thing since 1952.
Country Financial wants to know, what if you could own your future?
I mean, I would spend it with family and friends.
Travel more.
Retire.
Can make decisions that aren't fear-based about money.
At Country Financial, we take the time to get to know you so we can develop a plan with insurance and financial solutions to help you take charge of where you want to be.
Have that fear removed from my mind.
To help you own your future.
To be in control of your future.
Visit ownyourfuture.com to find a local Country Financial representative today.
Running Vikes up with 21 seconds left on the clock. Looking to pull out a win here at the DeVries Center. Long distance inbounds pass from Liggins. Picked off by King to Williams. King with the ball now. 12 seconds on the clock. Williams make a strong move to the hoop. He's going to let go by Pierce. Doesn't want to draw his fifth foul, and he comes away with a rebound with 7 seconds to go. And that's pretty much going to wrap it up here. Riker Pierce going to go to the line for two shots. Big bend up, 82-74 with 7 seconds to go.
You can hear the baseball players are starting to sing. Little hey, hey, goodbye.
That's never a good thing when the baseball players are singing.
I think they need to stick with baseball.
Pierce on the line, looking to salt this one away. First one, nothing but cord. 24 points for Pierce. Second one up and in. 25 points on the night for Pierce, leading him score in the ball game. 84-74. King off the glass and in.
Jordan King with the basket.
Bucket for Bellevue, gets him within eight. And that's going to do it, folks. And Big Bend is going to move on with a win here today at the DeVries Center, 84-76 over Bellevue. And we're going to step away for a quick commercial break and be back for the post-game wrap-up.
For the action next week beginning Thursday, March 10th.
To save some energy, I've used Einstein's mass energy equivalents to design the haptic suits you see in front of you. They will maintain our core body temperature while we completely turn off our heat and air conditioning. With the money we save on our Grant PD bill, I'll be expecting that trip to Disneyland this year.
You don't need to be a super genius to save energy and money. Visit grantpud.org to learn how.
Whether you're looking for a bigger car to support your growing family, a new truck for your business, or something to pull that toy of yours, we've got you covered at Barry Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram in Ephrata. Come see us today and learn why your family, friends, and neighbors buy their cars at Barry. On Basin Street for more than 35 years, and with locations in Moses Lake and Wenatchee, we are one great place to buy a car. Call or click 754-2411 or barrysaves.com.
We'll be right back.
Well, Big Ben comes away with a huge win here at the DeVries Center to advance to the Elite Eight next week at Everett. So great for opening first round win for Big Ben here against the Bulldogs, Duke.
Yeah, I know. It was a great game. You know, I got to give credit, though, to Bellevue. They came here and they fought. And they're loaded with talent. They are very young. But they have nothing to hold their head about. You know, they're going to move on as well in the consolation bracket. But I tell you what, they came to play tonight.
They really did. And too, I mean, I'll heap the praise on them as well because they were without their best player and one of the better defenders in the NWAC.
Yeah.
In Mr. Zur.
Zur, yeah.
Brian Zur. So, Bellevue gave him the Running Vikes a great test here in the first round of the opening tournament here.
They did. You know, it's good for Big Ben, you know. They move on to the Elite Eight now. You know, they survived basically today. And it was good for them because now you're in a... You're where you belong. That's where you wanted to be. And you got to step it up and play your best ball. And today wasn't the best they played, but they did what they had to do to get a win.
Yeah, they certainly did. And it was a total team effort out there tonight. And Riker Pierce was the leading scorer in the ball game with 25. He had Mogula Doe with 16, J.J. Elo with 15, Wyatt Johnson with 12, and then a good effort from a couple of guys on the Bellevue side as well.
Yeah, there was. You know, that Jack Walton was huge for them, and he ran into foul trouble, fouled out at the end. Calvin Dennis fouled out at the end, and that all has to do with Mogulado. You know, that he put so much pressure on the defense. And when you get those big guys for the other team in trouble, I mean, foul trouble, that's good for Big Ben.
Yeah, it certainly was, and it was a great afternoon here or evening at the DeVries Center, and everybody going away happy, at least the local guys. The Bellevue team has a little bit of a drive and a time to think about things for next week, but that's going to do it for our live coverage of the first round of the NWAC Regional Tournament here at the DeVries Center, and Big Ben again moves on to the Elite Eight and will play March the 11th in Everett at 4 p.m. against a yet-to-be-named opponent. So I want to thank everybody in the studio, our camera guys. Duke, been a pleasure working with you. I think this might be our last game of the season, so hope to be back again here next year with you. So great job, everyone, and have a great rest of the evening, and go Vikings.